Today we'll be making a holiday dinner for two, which includes pineapple ham, hash brown casserole, and a four ingredient beet winter salad. Ingredients for our winter beet salad. All you need is four ingredients, which are the beets, toasted walnuts that have been crushed, mayonnaise, and two cloves of garlic that I went ahead and chopped. You will need a garlic press and a grater. I'm also putting some plastic over my cutting board so that I don't get it dirty with the beet juice. Okay, so I'm gonna start by chopping some walnuts for our winter beet walnut salad that we're gonna make today. So first we're gonna open these beautiful walnuts. And we're gonna have a good amount of walnuts to chop. Let's say that's about half a cup. If you put a towel underneath your cutting board, it will not slide. We're gonna keep chopping the nuts until they're fine. And we are gonna be toasting these before they go into the beet salad. I'm just gonna keep on chopping. Okay, so chopping them was a lot of work, so why don't we just go ahead and use our Ninja food processor instead. So we're gonna go ahead and put the nuts into the food processor. I'm gonna make a big mess, but that's okay. Now all we gotta do is pulse. Alright, so these nuts are gonna be toasted. So I'm gonna take the blade out and pour the nuts onto the pan to toast on a medium heat. Periodically stir your walnuts to ensure they are toasting on all sides. Alright, so now I'm going to put down a towel. This will ensure that our cutting board does not slide, and we're going to take care of our beets. So here's a beautiful bunch of beets. We just cut some walnuts with this knife. And now you can use the leaves for other preparation, but we're gonna toss them. So all you're gonna do is cut the top and the bottom of the beet off. And then I just place all of the cuttings into the bag. And then we're gonna go ahead and rinse these before going ahead and cooking them. So now we have our clean beets that are ready to go into the water. This is cold water that we're putting them into. And now we're gonna go ahead and have them cook for about an hour. So set it and forget it. And while we're toasting our walnuts, and these are the main ingredients of our beet winter salad. All right, so now I'm going to peel the beets. I'm going to take a fork and stab it into my beetroot, and I'm just going to go ahead and peel the skin off. Should be pretty easy to do because they've been boiled. So I'm going to go ahead and peel it gently each beetroot. It just slides right off. Don't need a lot of pressure or anything. Alright, so this is the part where we grate the beet. I'm going to see if the big grate will give me the consistency I want, or if I want to go a little smaller. So this is the chunks I get. I'm just going to try this finer side to see if I like that a little bit better. I think I want a combination of the two, so I'm going to go ahead and grate one beet on the fine grater. Alright, so now we are done grating, and I'm going to go ahead and remove the grater. We're gonna go ahead and crush a clove of garlic in our garlic press. Crush it right in there. So I'm gonna test taste to see if I need a second clove or not. And then we're gonna add our walnuts. Two tablespoons to start, and some mayonnaise. And then we're gonna mix it all together. For our beautiful beet salad. And if you use vegan mayo, this could be a vegan recipe. You can add more walnuts to it if you'd like, or more garlic, depending on how you like it. It's also great to refrigerate it for about a half an hour for the flavors to combine together. Alright, so today we're going to cook this 1 pound ham that we found. This is a small size, so this is perfect for a household of two. This way we'll have some tonight for dinner, and then we're going to have some cooked ham left over for future meals as well, because this is a lot of meat for even two people. But really excited we found this. It does not have any nitrates or nitrites on it. This is something that I look for when I'm buying ham or when I'm purchasing hot dogs. So very simple. I'm gonna go ahead and open the packaging here. It's all right, so I got my ham and I got some sliced pineapple. And what I'm going to do is go ahead and put some pineapple right onto our ham. It's kind of a tradition here to go ahead and dress the ham with pineapple. And what you can do is you can put some toothpicks through to hold the pineapple in place. And the very last step of this is to throw some pineapple juice over the ham. So I will cook in some pineapple juice. And that's it. And we're going to put it in the oven together with the... We got a quarter cup of butter melting in a pan. And then we're going to take our onions. And we got some picky eaters here that want a finer chop. So if you don't like chunky chunks of onion, you'll want to chop them up even finer. So I'm going to throw them in the food processor here. And I prefer the taste of red onion in this dish. Some butter melting, and we're gonna put majority of the onion in. I'm gonna save some onion to use with my green beans, but otherwise I'm gonna put most of it in here. And we're just going to cook it until it's soft in the butter. This way you won't have the taste of raw onion in your potato casserole. We are gonna use a mix of sharp cheddar cheese, and I also want to add some Monterey Jack into it. So I'm gonna grate some. This is a soft cheese. It has a consistency close to a mozzarella, and we're gonna go ahead and just grate some to put mix together the cheeses. And I'm just gonna eyeball a good amount, because the more cheese, the tastier the casserole will be. You could always add more if you want, but it's gonna be approximately 8 ounces of cheese in the dish. So here's a good amount of cheese that we're going to use today. I'm going to use 26 ounces of frozen hash browns that have been de-thawed. You want about close to 30 ounces of potato, and you can use fresh hash browns as well, but this time around I could not find the fresh ones in the store, so we're using a bag of de-thawed hash browns for convenience instead. And this is where I'm gonna mix the drier ingredients together first, and then add the wet ingredients later. If you see any chunks of potato skin, you can go ahead and take them out. I'm gonna use a full 2 cups, 8 ounce bag of cheddar cheese. You can use a tiny bit less, because I am going to be mixing that Monterey cheddar that we shredded earlier. And I'm going to take a big spatula and mix it all together. And like I said, you could use more cheese if you'd like it more cheesy. We're gonna mix all of our wet ingredients. So we're gonna need 16 ounces of sour cream. Unfortunately, they ran out of the big tubs, so I'm gonna use 2 little tubs. I am using Daisy sour cream, as that's the brand that I like the best. So what I will do is I will mix all of the wet ingredients together with the seasonings, so that you will not get any clumps of garlic or salt in the dish. So here's 16 ounces of sour cream, and then we're gonna add a 10.5 ounce can of cream of celery soup. You can also substitute a meat-based soup if you prefer, or cream of mushroom. one came out really nicely. So here's our wet ingredients. I'm gonna mix them together. And this is where I'm gonna put the seasoning in to make sure it's really well distributed. I got some garlic and about a half a teaspoon or a quarter of a teaspoon of garlic. A little less, and some pepper. And I like to add it in the wet ingredients so that that flavor can be stirred in really well, because once you're going to start stirring it into the hash browns, it's going to be more difficult to evenly distribute all the seasoning. Got my big casserole dish out. The bigger the dish, the faster the potatoes will cook. And I'm gonna butter it, and I'm also going to put some olive oil in the dish. It's a little wet, just want to make sure it was clean. It's not a dish I use very often, but I'm gonna butter it a little bit, and I'm also gonna spray with some olive oil. Love olive oil sprays, very convenient. So go ahead and spray it generously, and the dish is prepped. I'm gonna add the cooked onion with the butter right into our liquids, and I'm gonna stir it. I don't want the onions to cook the cheese and melt it. So I'm gonna stir it in here first to cool them off. Also make sure that we are evenly distributing the onions. So I'm just gonna whip them into this soup and sour cream mixture. And then I'm gonna start incorporating the dry and wet ingredients. This is the hardest part of this dish, is mixing the two together. Make sure I get every part. So if you like cheese, onions, and potatoes, you're gonna like this dish. And now we're going to take the big spatula and mix it all together. You'll want to preheat your oven to 350 degrees for this, and this will cook in about 40 minutes to an hour. It's ready to eat when it's hot and bubbly and melted. So this is the consistency you should be getting. It's not too wet, but not too dry either. All right, I think it's ready to be going into the dish. Just literally falls in. optional crust you could put on here. You could put some breadcrumbs or chop up some croutons and make a crust. It doesn't need it, but because we got some picky eaters here, we're gonna do half potato chip crust and half no crust. Hold on to the bag of blades. And I'm just gonna crush it with my hand. Just rough crush it and I'll open it and crush it a little bit more. And I'm gonna peek inside to make sure I like the consistency of the crush. If I want a little more chop, I'll go ahead and do it. And then I'm just going to just put this crust with a spatula. And this will be the potato chip crust. Ready to go into the oven and bake. Wow, look at that beautiful color. So I'm gonna take the ham out first. Look at that. And then I'm gonna carefully take the casserole out.